the failing eyesight of my hairdresser. He's, of course, the current state of opera. And this season, as usual, was so exciting at the Met. But was broadcast in high defamation. Which Salome left out, well, she removed everything, even some of the high notes. I am not impressed by these updated Salomes. You all remember my Salome, I knew you would. It took place in the 1960s in Great Neck, Long Island. Well, she is the princess of Judea. I had 7 different color pieces of polyester that I took off during the dance of the cha-cha for 7 bells. I was a regular shmatahari. And after the dance, I demanded on a silver platter the head of Johnny Mathis. And then we had a dinner, this new production of La Tsunamula. Now, wasn't that something else? No, that certainly wasn't Tsunamula. But you know, I got so impressed with the way Mr. Say and Miss Zimmer this plain, simple, ordinary, little opera and transformed it into something truly excruciating. On that dangerous ledge, sleepwalking, I just wanted to stand up and scream, "Jump!" And then we had the most beautiful gala, the 125th anniversary of the Met, and the 40th anniversary of the debut of Placido Domingo. Or was it the other way around? Yes, it's in Placido, we've seen his first baritone role, Simon Boccanegra, and I think for him it would be the dawn of a whole new career. Well, you know what they say. Once you go Boccanegra, you never go back. Billy Bud Light. Mama, I can't believe it's not Father. I can't wait to see them. Well, you know, as I reached the twilight of what I've happened all my life in career, I wanted to make tonight about sharing with you some things what is very, very important to me, and this next selection certainly fits the bilge. It is by Maestro Berlioz, the composer of Les Troyens, the opera about Dido, Queen of Cartilage, and Aeneas, what comes to visit of it is Trojans. You know, legend has it that when I was growing up in Russia, my family lived in a beautiful dacha or country house. Truth? I was born in Chernomorskoye. Yes? It's just across the Karkinitsky Bay from Odessa. We lived in what could best be described as a hut. In fact, we didn't even have the entire hut. It was more like a pizza hut. I was the eldest of 32 brothers and sisters. It always amazed me my mother could have so many children, especially since she was a widow. I remember the talk in our village. Some people had the nerve to say, my mother was a loose woman. After 32 children, wouldn't be. Mostly we were starving. When everyone's in the blue moons, we would have a visit for my great-great-uncle Sergei, and then we ate good. Uncle Sergei, who was so aptly named, had seen a protege of great Russian ballerino, Nijinsky. Of course, that was many years earlier when Uncle Sergei was stripping young men. By this time, very old and very important in the KGB, the Kiev Gay Ballet. And all the little children in my family, I was his favorite, I loved him. There were so many famous dancers from Uncle Sergei's part of Russia. You might say he grew up in the dance belt. And he was so crazy, you know, he would just come over and sort of jeté around the hovel. And I would say to him, oh, Uncle Sergei, watch out, you're going to break something. And he would say, you don't own nothing. And I would say, no, no, I mean, you know, maybe a knee or a hip. And he would just laugh at me and say, oh, please. One day, I was going to have to see the Svetla della Rosa. That Nijinsky had choreographed the ballet, Le Spectre de la Rose, on Uncle Sergei to see how it looked. And then he showed me some of the moves Nijinsky had made on him. It was amazing. Even at that age, he could still get his legs up. Package caught up with me. Uncle Sergei had finally died and had leave me some of his things. I opened the package. Inside was some of his loveliest dresses. Oh. there was a jewel palace made for his sled dogs. Matusevgei was the only man in St. Petersburg that had for sled dogs poodles. There was a 3-minute Fabergé egg. He had this old piece of shit music. With the scribblings in Nijinsky's own hand for the Specter of the Rose. Oh, I was so moved to have this precious family heirloom. So I tucked it away as a memento until the millennium, when you was all immersed in 2KY. I swore never to sing it until tonight. Tonight, as homage to my beloved Uncle Stanley, I would like to perform on the Spectre de la Rose, into which I would attempt to incarcerate some of the generations, but Nijinsky made of my uncle. The song is sung by the flower to the young girl. Open your closed eyelid, but is touched by a virginal dream. I am the specter of the rose, plucked when I was still covered with coils of bark, and worn all night by you at your ball. I will come in your bed every night. But not this way. I don't want a mess or a funeral. My fragrance is my soul, and I come from paradise. Although I die, my fate is to be ended. For my tomb is your bazoo. And on that alabaster, the eye reposes, a poet once wrote with a kiss, here lies a rose, of whom all the kings in the world would be envious. It has been years. Please, you will forgive me if I make a mistake. I am, after all, a defective Russian.
Thank you.